village that was gradually abandoned because of the bitter memories it held of the death of more than 80 of its inhabitants. Family members lost under the rubble of a huge earthquake. That was the fate of Esfahak, a village that's 38 kilometers to the east of the city of Tabas in South Khorasan province. About 4 decades after it was completely devastated by an earthquake in 1978, the village of Esfahak has found new life and now serves as an ecotourism resort with one of the richest water resources in the Tabas region. As you can imagine, restoration on such a large scale isn't an easy task if you want to stay true to Esfahak's history. So far, 7 houses have been completed and are welcoming travelers with open arms. But that's not all. A mosque, the old school building that now serves as a research center for soil architecture and water, and several handicraft workshops are up and running as well.
در حقیقت داستان اسفهان داستان روایته، یعنی به دنبال روایتی که از قبل از زلزله برای ما گفته شده بود و خاطراتی گفته شده بود، به هر حال تصمیم گرفتیم که برگردیم و بیایم یه سری خونه ها رو مرمت کنیم با این هدف که بتونیم دوباره نسل قدیم و زندگی رو به بافت تاریخمون برگردیم. به هر حال حرف برای گفتن زیاد داشته.
The traditional bathhouse of Esfahak has its own appeal for tourists, and the sound of water running through its veins once again is proof of its revival. Even though Esfahak is mostly made of crumbling adobe walls, it really does have a character of its own. And what gives it a colorful facade is the many green fields scattered around it, with crops that are freshly harvested and used to create a variety of traditional dishes, new flavors and cuisines that can truly excite. Some Iranian cuisines are very similar to Middle Eastern dishes, where wheat acts as a staple holding everything together, just like this local Tabasi dish, which is called gannum polo and is made using crushed wheat. You can see gandum polo or wheat rice at any and all Tabasi tables, at special occasions and in ceremonies. Another interesting dish, which is especially prepared for mothers who've just given birth, is called khameh. It's a sweet dish which is made with caraway or Persian cumin, among other things. It's filled with different crushed nuts, a dry herb mixture, and sesame seeds that can lower your blood pressure and are rich in calcium. Breads are usually prepared differently depending on which region in Iran you live. For example, in Tabas, this bread is called qalifi and it's had for breakfast with date syrup. Another Tabasi traditional bread is known as kormaj. It's usually prepared by those who spend days on the road traveling, and interestingly enough, hot ash is used to bake it.
Sometimes the best recipes are the ones you simply whip up in a short amount of time. Eshkene is exactly like that, a dish that has many varieties here in Tabas.
As you can see, eshkene is like a broth. It's rather easy to make and is normally served with bread as an appetizer, at dinner time, or as light lunch.
don't forget sweets. The local pastry in Tabas is called qutab, which is an almond or walnut-filled deep-fried pastry. This crescent pastry originated in the city of Yazd, but the people of each region have their own way of making it. They are cooked all year round, but are particularly delightful in Nowruz during the New Year celebrations.
هر که آیا به تو بس صبح که شامش برود عاقبت مدت 6 ماه گرفتار آیه. این که گفتم به خاطر اینه که تبس از بس از لحاظ غذا و چیزاشوی ها و میوجاتش خیلی خوب و خوشته و مردمش خونگرم هستن بیشتر جذب تبس برن بیشتر به سوی تبس میین تا ای که مثلا ببخشه از تبس فاصله پیدا کنه امسال که یه نفر میمه سال دیگه 10 نفر به تبس میین.
On this trip, we made friends and memories that will last us a lifetime. And yes, this is the end of our journey, but there is still so much to be seen. I guess we'll have to leave the rest to you. This is Gulnar Farnoodi for Iran.